afternoon, everyone, and welcome, ladies, gentlemen, and most importantly, girls. It's fantastic to see 400 excited girls waiting to sing in an incredible historic venue like the Queen Elizabeth Hall, which has launched the careers of so many famous singers and musicians. So what a privilege it is to be here and to be ready to listen to all of you. We were especially pleased that every single one of our 25 junior and prep schools put forward a junior choir for this competition, and we were amazingly impressed by the standard of the entries. We'd originally planned to shortlist only 6 choirs for the final, but the judges found it so hard to make up their minds when they listened to the brilliance of your performances that we actually have 8 choirs in the final. Part of the vision of GDST is to really instill in girls a love of music, which we hope will be lifelong. Music is such a life enhancer, and we want to produce girls who are not only performers and singers and conductors and composers, but actually also girls who are audiences and critics. And this part, music has been part of GDST since our very earliest days. 140 years ago, class singing and harmony was on the timetable in our first GDST school. And of course, over the years, GDST has produced some fantastic, world-famous, world-class musicians. Everybody, of course, knows Jacqueline Dupre, who was a Croydon alumna, but we've also got the soprano, Elizabeth Watts, the violinist, Carenza Peacock, the clarinetist, Jane Hilton, composer, Emily Howard, and the concert pianist, Marion Stein, who later helped to found the International Leeds Piano Competition, which is one of the key world for concert piano. So many great musicians have taken their first steps in our school choirs and our school orchestras. And it's really wonderful that one of our GDST alumni, Elizabeth Llewellyn, is here today, and we are very grateful to you, Elizabeth, for your support. Elizabeth is one of our prestigious panel of 3 judges, and I'm going to tell you a little bit more about them all. Elizabeth was at Streatham and Clapham High School, and she studied at the Royal Northern College of Music and the National Opera Studio. She made her national debut as Mimi in La Bohème at English National Opera to great critical acclaim, and that led to her being named as Best Newcomer in Opera in 2010. In the years that have followed, she's gained uniformly glowing reviews in parts such as The Countess in Figaro and Michaela in Carmen. Her performance of Amelia in Simon Boccanegra won her the nomination as Singer of the Year 2013 in Opera Welt magazine. She won the inaugural Voice of Black Opera Competition Sir Willard White Award in 2009, and she was the opera nominee for the prestigious Breakthrough Award at the 2013 Times Sky Arts Southbank Awards. I hope that some of you today at this festival of music will follow in her footsteps and carry forward the great GDST tradition of choral singing for the next generation. We're so grateful to Elizabeth and her fellow judges, Sheila Wilson and Lynn Marsh, for giving their time to support our young singers. Lynn Marsh trained at Trinity College of Music and London University and has worked extensively in music education across all sectors. She's written for BBC children's programmes, both television and radio. She's written operas like Itoku for young singers and The New Chronicles of Man, which was a cycle of songs for primary children in the Isle of Man. I was lucky enough to hear the premiere of her cycle, Song of the Earth, her children's cantata, which was performed by our girls in the junior school at Blackheath High, together with children from their local Invicta Primary. And her songbook series, Songscape, is published by Faber. Last June saw the premiere of Wild Swans, which was commissioned and performed by the Halle Orchestra and their children's chorus. She's currently working as a world voice trainer for the British Council. Sheila Wilson is a prolific and popular composer of children's music. She started her career in 1990 writing Hosanna Rock, which went on to become a top-selling Christmas musical, still performed in hundreds of schools every year. She's written over 60 musicals, and her latest one, Gold, Frankincense, and Mirth, was performed in September and performed, published in September and performed by many schools last Christmas. And now, as always, her next composition is well underway. Sheila's music is performed around the world in schools, churches and theatres, on television and on the radio. And she also runs music workshops in schools and conferences, writes bespoke school songs, including the GDST's 140th anniversary song, and visits performances of her music around the country, one of her favourite occupations, and she's a guest speaker at school events. There are some others I'd also like to thank. Natalie Perks at Trust Office has worked tirelessly to ensure that today's event goes smoothly. Thank you, Natalie. And I want to thank all the staff in our schools who've helped the choirs in so many ways, supporting, conducting, rehearsing, and encouraging every singer to give of her best. Our particular thanks go to Wendy Archibald of Putney High School, who from the beginning has been a great source of advice and a wonderful sounding board. Lastly, of course, I should like to thank all today's performers. If the quality of the recordings is anything to go by, everybody in this hall is in for a real treat today. So this is a fabulous opportunity to celebrate the wealth of singing and that goes on in our schools and academies. I hope you all enjoy the afternoon. I wish all the performers the very best of luck, and I hope this day will stay in your memories as a really happy one for many years to come. Thank you. And now I'm going to hand over to Tom Beardmore Gray, who is our compere for the day.
Helen, thank you very much. Good afternoon, ladies, gentlemen, and girls. I'm so excited about this afternoon. I love singing, and I think that singing is a wonderful way to bring joy to other people. And I know that the girls this afternoon are going to bring tremendous joy to all of us. Could I ask first that everyone switches off their mobile phones, please? And without further ado, I'm going to ask the first school to come up on stage. It's Bromley High Junior School. And this choir is a choir with an international dimension. Many of the girls performing today are going off on a concert tour to Paris early tomorrow. And that tour includes a visit to sing in Disneyland, so that sounds good. And previous tours have been to Normandy, Bruges, and Brussels. So they're very accustomed to the big occasion. Their conductor is Leslie Clare, the deputy head and music teacher. Their pianist is Caroline Daniel, the director of music. They're going to be singing The Ash Grove, a Welsh folk melody arranged by Ruth Elaine Scram, and Roller Goaster, the words and music by Alan Simmons. So please can I welcome onto the stage the Bromley High Junior School Choir.
We're going up, we're going down, and then we stop, and then we stop.
us a flavour of what a treat we're in for this afternoon. I'd like to introduce now the choir of Prep School, and Kensington Prep School, as many of you will know, is quite close to here on the Fulham Road. It has a very rich tradition of singing, and they perform quite regularly at some major venues in London, including St John Smith Square and Cadogan Hall. This afternoon, their conductor is Jonathan Burgess, the director of music, and their pianist is Olivia Travers. They're going to be singing Boots of Shining Leather, which is a traditional Hungarian song, and Comedy, the words and music by Stephen Sondheim, arranged by Sally Albrecht. So can I welcome on stage the Kensington Prep Choir. So I'm told that the choir is not quite ready yet and will be on stage in a couple of minutes. So while we're waiting, I can just give you a little bit more detail about the choir and what they've recently been engaged in, as well as performing at those London venues that I mentioned. They've toured abroad in Belgium, Holland, and Germany. And in 2016, they will be travelling to Venice and giving four performances in conjunction with the School Chamber Orchestra. So they have a very busy agenda. And everyone in the school is involved in singing, and this is just one of three choirs at Kensington Prep. At present, 97% of girls at Kensington Prep learn an instrument, and most of the choir members are involved in the school's orchestra. So you can see that Kensington Prep is a school that is very dedicated to music. I'm told that they're on their way, so that's good news. You may know also that Kensington Prep is the only school in the GDST which is a junior school only. Almost all of our, in fact, all our other schools are 3 to 18, but Kensington Prep is a junior school only. And here they come. So please welcome onto the stage the Kensington Prep Choir.
If you dance and you must have boots of shining leather. If you dance and you must have boots of shining leather.
And many congratulations to the choir of Kensington Prep. That was absolutely fabulous. So next up on stage is going to be Putney High Junior School. So Putney has a very rich tradition in singing, with all the girls in years 5 and 6, 95 in all, belonging to the choir, and they perform in and out of school. And for events such as today's competition, they form a smaller choir. And in the last 7 years, the small choir has been runners-up in the BBC Junior School Choir of the Year competition, 3 times appearing on television. In December, the choir was invited to take part in a Christmas charity concert, sharing the programme with celebrity singers. And just 2 weeks ago, the choir was performing over the road in the Royal Festival Hall as part of a concert in aid of the charity Barnardo's. Today, the conductor is Wendy Archibald, the junior school director of music, who has played such a large part in putting this event together. And the pianist is Joe Nichols, a senior school music teacher. They will be performing One Fine Day, The Words and Music by Mary Donnelly, arranged by George L.O. Strid, and The Rhythm of Life, words by Dorothy Fields, music by Cy Coleman, arranged by Roger Emerson. So I'd like to welcome on stage, if they're ready to come, the Putney High Junior School Choir. Yeah, I think they are on their way. I can see the door opening and the little person peering round. Not quite ready. So let me tell you a little bit more about Putney High School. Yes, here they come.
Thank you.
congratulations to the Putney High School Junior School Choir. That was absolutely fabulous. The next act on stage is from Brighton and Hove School, which is our first out-of-town school. As many of you will know, GDST has 26 schools across the UK. 13 of them are in the London area, and the other 13 are scattered around big cities around the UK. Brighton and Hove School are here today. Their choir meets during one lunchtime each week, and it's non-selective and open to all girls from years 4 to 6. And there are normally 85 to 90 members. So for the purposes of today, they've had to take the unusual step of holding auditions. And their soloist, Daisy, was chosen only 2 weeks ago and very bravely stepped up to the challenge. They found that synchronising the moves for one of their pieces, This Little Light of Mine, has been quite a task, and they've learnt a lot about dedication, focus, teamwork, and the importance of practice. And in doing so, they've enjoyed it every step of the way. The conductor today is Miriam Roberts, who is head of junior school music, and the pianist is Poppy Hyde. They'll be performing The Lily and the Rose, composed by Bob Chilcott, and This Little Light of Mine, a jazz spiritual arranged by Gwyn Arch. So would you please welcome on stage the Brighton and Hove School Junior School Choir. Thank you. congratulations to the Brighton and Hove Junior School Choir. That was another wonderful performance. This event has been organised so efficiently that we're running a little bit ahead of schedule, which is great. We're going to have a break now for about half an hour, so if everyone can be back in their seats by 10. What you've still got to look forward to are performances from Oxford High Junior School, Newcastle High School for Girls, South Hampstead High School Junior School, and Wimbledon High School. So lots more to come, and enjoy the break.
complimentary ice creams are in service in the foyer. If you leave your prayer and go to the room for your company. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Ladies, gentlemen and girls, welcome back to the second half. We're going to be treated in the second half first to Oxford High Junior School Choir. Let me tell you a little bit about the singing at Oxford High. Everybody at Oxford High Junior School sings with their year group every week, and everyone takes part in a musical show each year, again with their year group. And they like singing so much that they meet after school every Monday to do even more. Next term they're going to be singing in a workshop with Bob Chilcott, who is coming over to work at the school with singing leaders from all over the GDST, as well as other local school teachers. And the Oxford High Junior School Choir sing at all the big events at the school, such as the Harvest Concert, the Christmas Concert, and the Summer Concert. And sometimes they enter the Oxford Music Festival, and they've won their class 6 times at that festival. Last weekend they sang at the Music for Youth Regional Festival in Oxford. Today their conductor is Sophie Reynolds, and their other conductor is Camilla Stevenson. Their pianist is Louise Taylor, who's the director of music. The two pieces that they're going to sing are Harvest, composed by Mark Russell, and Cantar, composed by Jay Althaus. So will you please welcome on stage the Oxford High School Junior School Choir. Thank you. Well, many congratulations to the Oxford Junior High School Choir. And we're now moving on to Newcastle. And Newcastle is a school which is very, very close to our hearts here in London, even though it's many miles away. Some of you may know that recently we merged our own school with another school called Church High to form a new school called Newcastle High School for Girls. And that's in its first year of operation. And the junior school is doing terrifically well. It's one of our biggest junior schools and occupies a lovely site called Chapman House. So we're delighted that they're with us today. And I'd assume that they'd come down here last night, but not a bit of it. They all got up jolly early and got here in good time all the way from up north. So well done to them. Today, their conductor is Jill Brown, who is the junior deputy head. Their accompanist is Janet Kirkham, who is a key stage one phase leader. Spanish is the core foreign language for girls at Newcastle High School, and the verses to one of their songs, Oye, is sung in Spanish. And that's the first song that you'll hear, the words and music by Jim Papoulis. And the second song, Amazing Grace, by Pachelbel's Canon, arranged by Jean Anne Schafferman. So will you please welcome onto the stage Newcastle High School for Girls Junior School. Thank you. Newcastle High School for Girls' 600-mile round trip today. I really think they deserve a round of applause. So, our penultimate performance comes from South Hampstead High School, Junior School, and I actually have a personal experience this term of what great singers and musicians these girls are going to become, because some of you may know that we completely rebuilt the senior school at South Hampstead, and it opened officially on January 28th. We had the official opening, and we had an absolutely wonderful concert at that opening performance, where the standard was outstanding across the school, and I know that since that they've had a wonderful musical, Les Miserables, performed at the senior school, and they've got a big senior school concert coming up at St John Smith Square, I think later this week. So there's a tremendous tradition at South Hampstead for really top class music. And it's clear that that tradition exists in the junior school as much as the senior school. So, today, the conductor of the junior school choir is Kate Rattenbury, who's the director of music, and the pianist is Alice Turner. They are going to be singing, firstly, Feed the Birds, the words and music by Richard M. Sherman and Robert B. Sherman, arranged by Christy Carey Miller, and The Rhythm of Life, the music by Cy Coleman, and lyrics by Dorothy Fields, arranged by Richard Barnes. So please welcome onto the stage the South Hampstead High School Junior School Choir. Well, many congratulations to South Hampstead High School, Junior School, that was fabulous. And we're now going across town to SW19, to Wimbledon High School for Girls. And one of the notable things about the year five and six choir is its size, and we haven't got all of the girls here today, just 50 of them. And one of the things that I've been told is that the girls here, as is so often the case with talented musicians, they're very involved in lots of other activities as well. They're very keen in the classroom, they're very keen on the sports field, they're pulled in all sorts of directions, but they love their music. And many in this choir will be taking part in a music tour to Belgium in late June. So if you'd like to hear them again, they'll be singing at the Menin Gate as part of the last post-ceremony on the 26th of June, two churches and the seaside town of Dupin on Sunday the 28th of June. Today, their conductor is Kristen Calloway, who is the head of junior music, and the pianist is Richard Bristow, the director of music. Their two songs are Banua, which is a traditional Liberian song, and Get Happy from Summer Stock, the words and music by Curler and Arlen, arranged by Mac Hoof. So please welcome on stage Wimbledon High School Junior School Choir.
Thank you.
ladies, gentlemen and girls, many congratulations to Wimbledon High School for Girls, a fabulous performance. And I think now is a good time, now we've heard all of the acts, I think for the adults to show their appreciation for all of the pupils for the wonderful singing this afternoon. The judges are now going to go backstage and deliberate, and my goodness, I don't envy them the task. I think they've got a very difficult job. One of the things that I felt was that all of the performers, you know, they didn't go for the easy options. They went for very challenging pieces of music and sang them beautifully. So a lot of deliberation, I'm sure. Whilst the judges are deliberating, I'm going to ask our chairman of GDST, Dr. Tim Miller, to come up onto the stage, and he is going to present some certificates and medals to one representative of each of the choirs, and then we'll then go out for a break before coming back in to hear who the winner is. So could I ask that one representative from Bromley High Junior School come up on stage to receive their certificates and medals from Dr. Miller. Next up, could we have one representative from Kensington Prep School, please? And a representative from Putney High Junior School. And a representative from Brighton and Hove Junior School. And next up, Oxford High Junior School. And next, Newcastle High School for Girls Junior School. A representative from South Hampstead High School Junior School. And finally, a representative from Wimbledon High Junior School. Thank you very much, girls, and if we could aim to be back in our seats at 3:05, we will hear who the winner of the first GDST Young Choir of the Year competition is. Ladies, gentlemen and girls, if I could ask you to take your seats, please. Our three honoured judges, Elizabeth Llewellyn, Lynn Marsh and Sheila Wilson, are now going to address us and give you all some feedback on the performances.
Hello, can you hear me? Oh, yes, you can. I have to apologise because I've got very little voice, unlike all of you people on the stage today. I've been struggling with a cold, you all know what that's like. So, firstly, a massive thank you. We've had just the most amazing day. It's been like, you know, a free concert that's gone on, and we've just loved every performance. Have you had a good time?
Yes!
Hopefully. You've done lots of things. You've performed for us, you've been rehearsing for ages, and you finally got to be on the stage at the Queen Elizabeth Hall. And also, you've heard all these other choirs, and I'm sure you've learnt a lot of things by just watching, even maybe the way they walk on the stage, or the way they smile, or the songs they've chosen to sing, or what they do with them, maybe if they've added movement. So you've had lots of things to kind of enjoy and learn as well. And it's a wonderful occasion to have everybody together to just hear all this fantastic singing. It really has been. The part singing, the choice of repertoire, the different languages, unaccompanied songs. It's been a real joy. So that's just a big thank you from all of us for what we've had today. And a big thank you to all your teachers who've worked so incredibly hard, and their accompanists as well. So thank you very much.
Thank you. I hope mine's on too. Yes, good. It has been the most super day. As a performer, you don't often, myself, I don't often get to sit back and listen to music and just enjoy being entertained. And it's such a privilege and such a joy. So thank you so much. It reminded me a great deal of when I was at school. I was at Streatham High, another GDST school, and we had such a wonderful time singing in choir with our friends and making new friends and learning incredible music. So it's been a lovely trip down memory lane for me. One thing that I would really congratulate you on and encourage you to do more is that there are lots of technical things we can get right, lots of rhythm and getting the notes right and getting the pitch right, but ultimately singing comes from here, from your heart and from your gut, and it involves storytelling and drawing your audience into your world, and that's what makes singing so exciting to listen to and to be part of in a choir. And we saw so much of that today. So that was such a privilege for us to see and hear some amazing stories being told and some beautiful heartfelt communication. So thank you all very much.
Well, hello, wonderful children of GDST. That was an absolutely spectacular, spectacular concert. We've had such a great time, as we've all said. Each choir was amazingly good. And, of course, you know that because you've made it to the finals from 25 schools, which is such a wonderful achievement. So well done to all of you. You were absolutely brilliant. It was so difficult for us to choose a winner today. And so I'm glad that you've all had the wonderful experience of singing here, because that's probably going to be one of the real memorable points of your life, one of many wonderful memorable points of your life. I don't think you will ever forget this. We all took lots of notes during each of our performances, and so many wonderful things we've said about them, but I'm just going to read a few tiny things from each performance. And then you'll find out who's won. First of all, Bromley. Gosh, Bromley, well done for going on first. It's so hard, isn't it? But you did it spectacularly well. Well done. And we really liked the way you announced your own song. That was lovely. Well done. You had lovely phrasing and very good tuning, and you paid great attention to detail. And we also liked your lovely synchronized movements very much. So let's give a big clap to Bromley. Well done. Brilliant. Well done, Bromley. Kensington, you sang unaccompanied, which was very good. Well done. You did that very well. And you had a fabulous start to that. And we all felt you sang beautifully in unison. And you had a very relaxed presence on the stage, which we enjoyed. And you had an absolutely superb quality of musicianship. So well done, Kensington. Putney. Now, Elizabeth said this made the hairs on her arm stand on end, and it almost reduced her to tears. That's how lovely it was. You had a real commitment to text, and you communicated beautifully, and you were very engaging. Well done. And you had great physical commitment to your singing as well. And a real tangible joy of singing was communicated in what you did. And you have really excellent performance skills. So very well done to you. I'm trying to keep this short, but it's hard. Brighton and Hove. Well, you had a wonderful, warm, clear tone. And Daisy, congratulations to you. Where are you, Daisy? Give me a wave. Well done. My goodness, you've done something I've never done. You've sang solo in the War Festival Hall. Isn't that wonderful? Fantastic. Well done. As a choir, you were engaging, entertaining, and you had some beautifully, beautifully sustained harmonies on really quite hard intervals. We were very, very impressed with that. And very detailed dynamics. So very well done, Brighton and Hove. Oxford High. Oh, you had absolutely lovely unison singing. Well done. Really super. And very good harmonies, clear words, and very good timing. And also, it was really lovely that you sang in Spanish as well. So that was an excellent performance. Very well done. Newcastle High. We thought you presented nicely at the very beginning. You really had a super presence on stage and a very good beginning. You had good dynamics. Another lovely song in Spanish. Well done. We put here that your performance was bright, energetic, and it had really lovely tones. So well done, you. South Hampstead High School. You had a great sound. It really achieved a lot of volume. Well done, but it never sounded forced. And you had some lovely, sincere storytelling that we really liked. Your faces lit up, and you had a great energy and excitement. Well done. You really made us care about what you were singing about. And also, you had a great range. You sang some superb low notes really well, and also some lovely high phrases too. So well done, Southampton. We're nearly there. Right, last one, Wimbledon, last but not least. Well done, Wimbledon. You had a great range of dynamics, lovely contrasts, well done. Very good part singing, lovely clear enunciation, and you also, we noticed you all listened to each other very well, and that's very important when you're singing. And I must say, also, all of you followed your conductors very well as well, so well done, Wimbledon. But what you really want to know is who we've decided was the winner, don't you? And as I said, it was so hard, and I'm going to hand over the brown envelope now. And I can tell you that we loved all the performances, but we were looking for everything. We were looking for very good technicality and musicianship, but also a real love and a passion in your singing. And we did all agree together on the winner. And the winner is...
Ladies and gentlemen, the Young Choir of the Year 2015 is, if I can get it open, well, we've made it. So, ladies and gentlemen, girls, the winner is South Hampstead. Can I ask the girls and staff of South Hampstead High School to come down and collect their winners' medals? Ladies, before you go. A small something.
Thank you.
and gentlemen, in conclusion, many congratulations to South Hampstead High School for Girls. It's tough that there can only be one winner, because we've seen 8 wonderful performances this afternoon. We'd like to say a big thank you to the judges, who I think had a very, very difficult job, but that did it wonderfully. And a big thank you to everyone who supported this event, including the parents who have come here today, who we haven't mentioned, and we're really happy to see you here today and supporting the girls. I'm sure we're going to do this again, so safe journey home this evening, whether you're going up the M1 to Newcastle or just to the Fulham Road, and we look forward to seeing you hopefully next year. Thank you very much.